Hey, it's Allison from computers.com with a quick video about how to block those irritating spam texts on your iPhone, iPad, or Mac. Just this morning, I received a text message from AT&T saying that my bill was paid and that I should click on this link for a free gift. There's nothing technically sophisticated about this message. Most fifth graders could send it, but it is a great example of clever social engineering because many people are so happy to have their bill paid and get a gift that they follow the directions without thinking. Note that the sending number is a regular 10-digit phone number, which is not what most big corporations use. We'll talk more about how to tell in a moment, but first we're going to look at what to do when you receive a spam text. Most important, do not click the link, because it will likely take you to a site that tries to steal your login information. If you already clicked on it, but you didn't do anything else, you're probably not in trouble. But if you did click on it and then entered your login information, it would be smart to change your password for that site immediately. If you realize that this was spam, you might also be tempted to respond in, shall we say, an unfriendly way. As satisfying as that might be in the moment, all that does is let the spammer know that they've reached a real person, so don't do that either. What you should do instead is block this phone number. It's easy once you know how, but it's not so obvious how to do it. Here's how to block this number on your iPhone or iPad. Tap the little head above the phone number. In the next window that appears, tap the Info button right here, and then tap the option to block this caller. You'll see a warning that you won't be able to get calls or texts from this person in the future. Just confirm and you're all set. Now you can back up to the previous window and tap Done. Note that this does not delete the message. You can do that separately if you want to. Here, by the way, is what a real text message from AT&T looks like. Note that the sending number is not a regular 10-digit number, and they spell AT&T correctly with the ampersand. As we explained in the video linked above, you can often spot spam by the misspellings and bad grammar. Now let's look at how to do this on a Mac. Here's the same message in the Messages app on a Mac. Confusingly, clicking on the Info button doesn't bring up the block option, nor does the drop-down arrow next to the number. Instead, you have to use the menu at the top of the screen. With the offending message selected, click Conversations on the menu bar. Choose Block Person on the Conversations menu, and then click Block to confirm. And you're done. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.mom videos.